Hello. In the previous lectures, we have studied the type of polarization and the methods of polarization. In this lecture, we will study the optical activity. So let us start with the analysis of the light, whether it is polarized or not. And if it is polarized, then the type of polarization. We incident the light on a rotating nicole or a rotating polarizer. By doing so, the light can show the variation in intensity with minimum equal to zero. If it is so, then the incident light is the plane polarized light. And it is also possible that the variation in intensity are shown, but the minimum is not equal to zero. It is possible if incident light is either elliptically polarized or partially polarized. Third case is possible when there is no change in intensity, and in this case there is a possibility of incident light to be unpolarized or to be circularly polarized. Now pass this light from the quarter wave plate, and as we know that a quarter wave plate can interchange elliptically polarized light and the linearly polarized light into each other. So if this light is elliptically polarized, then this will be a linearly polarized light now. And if this light is further passed by the rotating nicole, then variation in intensity will be observed with minimum is equal to zero. And this will show that this light was elliptically polarized. And there is another possibility of partially polarized light. If this partially polarized light is passed through the quarter wave plate and then from the rotating nicole, then there will be no change in its state. So there will again the variation in intensity will be observed with minimum not equal to zero. In this condition, we again use the quarter wave plate because there is a one possibility of circularly polar light in this case. So this quarter wave plate will convert this circularly polar light into linearly polar light, and after passing through a rotating nicole, this will show the variation in intensity with minimum equal to zero. But the other possibility of unpolarized light will not be changed by either the quarter wave plate or the rotating nicole. So there will be no variation in intensity if the incident light is unpolarized. Now let us talk about optical activity. There are some materials like quartz or sugar crystals, they can rotate the plane of vibration of plane polarized light when this plane polarized light is passed through them. This property of rotating the plane of vibration of plane polarized light is known as optical activity. And this phenomena is called optical rotation. The angle through which the plane of polarization is rotated by these materials is called the angle of rotation. If the rotation of plane of vibration is clockwise, then this is right-handed or positive or dextrorotatory rotation. And if this rotation is anti-clockwise, then it is known as left-handed or negative or lever-rotatory rotation. This angle of rotation is directly proportional to the length of the substance and concentration of the substance. So this angle of rotation can be given by some coefficient times length of the substance multiplied by the concentration of substance. This S is known as the coefficient of specific rotation or simply specific rotation. The instruments which measure the specific rotation of any optically active material are known as polarimeters. Lorentz half-sheet polarimeter is one of the examples. The most important part of Lorentz half-sheet polarimeter is half-sheet plate. So, half-sheet plate must be discussed before discussing Lorentz half-sheet polarimeter.
A Lorentz half-sheet plate consists of a semicircular half-wave plate ABC, this, of quartz, and a semicircular glass plate ADC, this. The quartz plate is cut parallel to the optic axis, and the thickness of glass plate is so adjusted that the absorption of light is the same in both the parts of the half-shaped plate. The plane of vibration of the plane polarized light incident normally on the half-shaped plate is along PQ. Here, PQ makes angle theta with vertical optic axis. The vibrations emerge from the glass plate as they are. Inside the quartz plate, the light is divided into two components, one along optic axis and one perpendicular to optic axis. So OL is the extraordinary ray and OM is along ordinary ray. As quartz is a positive crystal, so these two components travel along the same direction but with different speeds, and on emergence a phase difference of pi is introduced between them. Due to this phase difference, the direction of ordinary component is reversed. So the ordinary component OM becomes OM. Now the resultant of extraordinary component OL and ordinary component ON will be OR, making an angle theta with y-axis. Thus, the vibration of the beam emerging out of quartz will be along RS. So these are the vibrations which are emerging from the quartz, and these are the vibrations which are emerging from the glass plate. This is the situation when the light will emerge from the half-shaped plate. The angles of both the vibrations from the optic axis is the same, which is equal to theta. So if a polarizer with vertical optic axis is placed adjacent to the half-shaped plate, it will show that the intensity of both the half parts is the same, because the angle of both the emerged lights will be the same with the optic axis of the polarizer. Now, if the polarizer is rotated clockwise by some angle, then this component will make smaller angle with the optic axis, while this component will make a higher angle with the optic axis of the polarizer. So by the Malus law, it is clear that this part will appear dark and this part will appear brighter. And if this polarizer is rotated anticlockwise, then the situation will be reversed. Therefore, depending upon direction of optic axis of the polarizer, any one half part of this half-shaped plate can appear dark, and that's why this plate is known as half-shaped plate. Now we will discuss the working of Lorentz half-shaped device. In this device, the unpolarized light is passed through a polarizer, and then the polarized light is passed through the half-shaped plate. When this polarized light passes through half-shaped plate, the situation is like this. When these two types of rays are passed through the optically active material, then this material rotates the plane of polarization of both the rays by some angle, depending upon the length of this tube and the concentration of the material in this tube. First, consider the situation when this material is absent from this place. So the light would pass through the half-shaped plate, and when this analyzer would see these light rays, the intensity of both the parts of the half-shaped plate would appear with the same intensity. Now the tube filled with optically active material is placed at the path of the light. So these all components of lights are rotated by some angle. So this is the situation at the right end of the tube. But analyzer is placed in the older situation only. And in this case, these vibrations will show the high intensity and these vibration will show the lower intensity. So by introduction of this optically active material, the intensity, which was same for both the parts of half shade plate, becomes now half dark and half light. So to achieve the previous position of the same intensity again, this analyzer will have to be rotated. The angle by which this analyzer will have to rotate it to get the previous situation is the angle by which this optically active material have rotated these plane of vibrations. In this way, we can find the optical rotation introduced by a given length and given concentration of this optically active material.